campaign pointed to his promise to create a police oversight board within the first 100 days of his presidency, as well as reports that other advocacy groups, including the NAACP, have supported community policing. However, they did not directly respond to the letter. Shannon.
Hi, Jackie Heinrich in New York for us tonight. Thank you.
You got a head over a barrel.
The young black voters might not show up for Biden, saying police brutality has spurred young African Americans to take to the streets. But it's far from clear they'll go to the polls. Let's dig a little deeper tonight with the executive director of the National Diversity Coalition for Trump, Bruce Lavelle. Welcome back, Bruce. Good to see you.
Yeah, thanks for having
me. Joe's got some explaining to do.
There's more pressure on the former Vice President Biden to be tougher when it comes to the police reform ideology. Today, President Trump rolling out his plans. This is how the
he's got to do everything that the Black Lives Matter wants him to do.
Trump's executive order is toothless and meaningless. We don't need studies. We need police that commit crimes to be punished. All police that use chokeholds claim their lives were threatened. What's new?
Who's this joker, Reverend Al? Well, if these dummies don't give themselves a COVID, we might be all right. These dumb protesters standing right next to each other. Where's the social distance? I don't see it. I see a bunch of knuckleheads. Living in a fantasy land. Let's hope we become better after this. Can only hope and pray.
Listen, everyone's on notice because the commander in chief has spoken.
All right, Bruce.
Awkward silence.
And we'll see how this plays out. And hopefully, as you and I talked about during the commercial, there can be some apolitical or bipartisan effort at meeting each other in the middle of getting some
tit for tat. Exactly.